Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, you're going to learn how to deal with sailing over the handlebars of your own bicycle with a brake proportioning valve. Let's go! Your vehicle has been engineered to have the right amount of brake front and back so it can stop the vehicle reasonably well. And under normal driving, you can have pretty equal pressure front and back, and it's all going to be fine. Where it's a problem is under heavy braking, where a bus full of nuns pulls out in front of you and you slam on the brakes and the whole vehicle goes, aah! You got all this weight going on the front and you're gonna need the brake pressure up there on the front. But on the back, all that weight has come off the back. And now, if you have the equally high pressure on the back of your vehicle, you're gonna lock up those wheels, they'll skid, the back of the wheel comes around, and you're like, oh! So, what we want to do in an emergency situation is limit the amount of brakes that goes to the back. We're going to limit the pressure going to the back. And for that, you need one of these. Brake proportioning valve. They come from lots of different manufacturers. This is one I picked up from my 61 Chevy Apache. Check up the link up here to see the rest of the build of that vehicle. But this guy, through frickin' black magic and voodoo, it takes the pressure that goes to the back of your vehicle, it allows the pressure to increase with the front to a point, and then it's kind of limits, it stops that pressure. The front can keep going, but the back is kind of limited. Now, on a normal vehicle, you got a proportioning valve already in there, and it is engineered for the kind of brakes you have, the kind of weight distribution you have, the center of gravity you have, the whole bit that makes up the brakes of your car is set and engineered. Where it's a problem is if you've gone and changed things. So my 61 Chevy pickup has brake master cylinder from one vehicle, calipers from another, back brakes are mixed of different things. It's a whole hodgepodge of whatever, and none of it's engineered to work together. So in this case, this guy is adjustable. Let me pop it out of the container. Pop! Whoops. I'm not gonna disassemble and show what's going on inside, but this is the inlet side. You put a brake line into here, brake line there goes to your brakes. And then you can adjust this and it kind of changes the pressure that you can get. You want more back pressure? Looks like you turn this in to tighten up a spring and you can have more and more back pressure getting to the back wheels before it shuts off. It doesn't shut off, it stops climbing. Or if you need less, and you can turn it around that way. So you put it in the vehicle and go and hit the brakes really hard. If the back brakes lock, that's death on a corner. So you dial this in to make it not lock. You want your front brakes locking, not your back brakes. These are not DOT approved. They're not legal in a vehicle, but they're smart to have. And if you want it to be safe, and you've screwed with things, like I screw with things, you're gonna want one of these. They're handy. So I'm putting one in. I'm also gonna put it under the hood near the master cylinder so I hopefully don't screw with it while I'm driving, because that would be dumb. Pickups in particular can be a little fussy with brake proportioning valves, because clearly if it's a truck, you're gonna haul something. And the brake proportioning that you need when it's empty and when it's full can be two different things. So some manufacturers have added a feature so that it senses load. They call it a load sensing proportioning valve. And it's usually a little lever which goes to a little bit of a valve. So if the truck's really heavily loaded, boop, and the back end is like hanging down there, if the back end's really heavily loaded, it says, oh, I say, oh boy, give me some more brake fluid. And it would increase the pressure to the back brakes. And similarly, if the truck's completely empty, the back of the truck's like, no, no, we're good, we're good. My father bought a Toyota Tundra years ago, brand new, and he bought the biggest freaking camper that would fit on the back of the truck. I think it weighed 2,000 pounds. And he put it on the truck and the truck's and the back brakes are, ye gods, crank up the pressure. And it would be okay to stop, except there was so much camper, the thing kind of would hit the bump stops. So we put in airbags. So it sits level. So now your truck's carrying 2,000 pounds, the maximum of its capacity, and you've pumped up the air so it rides okay. And the brake proportioning valve is going, yeah, we're not carrying nothing. Don't worry, we're good. Which isn't true, but the sensor doesn't know that we aired it up and it's actually not carrying anything. So the front brakes would be destroyed after one long trip. come back from a trip, new rotors, new calipers, new pads. Go out on another trip, come back, new rotors, new pads, no calipers, always replacing the front brakes on that Toyota because the fronts were doing all of the work. And the backs are like, yeah, there's nothing to see here, man, we're good. Problem. Same kind of thing, I had a Nissan mini truck, a hard body, D21 if you want to do like JDM tight speak, yo. And like an idiot, I lowered it quite a bit. And the load sensing proportion valve in the back of the Nissan mini truck was like, oh my gosh, we have a house on top of us. And we didn't. But it would put all kinds of brake pressure on the back and you'd step on the brake, wah! It would spin wildly out of control. So all I did is I went, oh, here's the bracket. Well, and I lowered it too much. Oh, well, let's just move the bracket down so it doesn't know I'm lowered. And it was fine. It was dandy. It was a good way to go. Square body Chevy pickups. They started to introduce load sensing proportioning valves and the factory authorized GM approved dealing with a customer who's complaining about this load sensing proportioning valve. Yeah, if the customer complains, here's how you bypass it. Carry on. My 61 Chevy pickup, I don't think it has any proportioning valve at all. So who knows? But safety features, who needs those? You do. And it's called a brake proportioning valve. Get the right one. Have a good day. Thanks for watching, eh? Why? Why do you have to turn on the furnace? Can't you see I'm busy?